the entire canon Shindo story so far. You may not know it, but Railgame's popular game, Shindo Life, has an actual storyline, where characters, drama, and of course, Shinobi are all included. Welcome everyone to today's video, where I'm going to be going over and explaining the entire canon Shindo Life story so far. Details. First, you must understand what counts as canon and what counts as non-canon. The things I consider canon in this video are anything with a backstory or a story at the moment. Stuff like Shindo Life events, release scripts, clans, etc. Anything that isn't canon is just things that are there since it's a game. These things being game modes, regular bloodlines, and such. I'm going to be counting the Shindo CC community as a borderline canon, since most things that happen on CC are technically planned off and based off of the original storyline, but there's also non-canon stuff like fights and training. Anyways, let's get right to it. Background. There are several clans in the Shindo story, but the most notable ones are Akuma, Uchiha, Shizune, Senju, Senko, Namikaze, Azurashi, Uzumaki, Seishin, Yamanaka, and the Joki, Hyuga. Just like Naruto, there are leaders of different villages called the Kage. Prologue story. Not much is known of the story that takes place before the main timeline, but one thing that we do know is that there was once an Akuma member and a Senju member, who battled out so hard that their destruction created a valley which was later named Shindai Valley. You can play in this map. These two individuals are named Shindai Akuma and Raiken Shizune. Shindai Akuma is said to be the strongest Shindo of all time. Another important character who you will need to know of later on is Rengoku. Rengoku has one of the most powerful eyes in Shindo history. Main story. The main story follows a team. The following part is not confirmed, but it's assumed that in this team is D.Va, Alpharaima Akuma, and Forged Akuma. Remember those names. Their sensei is Bankai Akuma. Forged Akuma has two brothers, Ryon Akuma and Shiver Akuma. Sometime before year 250, D.Va attacks the Ember Village. There is an unknown cause for this, but we do know that it is not due to Sensei Bankai's death. More on that later. This part goes by kind of quickly since it doesn't really have much impact on the story other than D.Va becoming a criminal and a new Ember Village being remade in YC 250. A few years later, on YC 256, Sensei Bankai Akuma passes away. Now we get to the main kind of story. Forged Akuma only has one eye, which is sad for an Akuma since you can't unlock your samurai spirit without one, and gives up on becoming a Shindo. But his brothers, Ryon and Shiver, betrayed Forged and are now leading Ember and, as Forged says, is being manipulated. Forged didn't like the way Ember was heading and started training to try to change Ember. During a few months period during his training, his friends Alpharaima, Satori, and his former teammate D.Va, who is now also a criminal for destroying the Ember Village, checks up on him. After a few months, a mysterious figure appeared before Forged, offering power to, quote, change this accursed world. Forged falls to the ground crying, saying,
"My brothers couldn't understand my reasoning, my ideals. What makes you think that you'll understand me?"
The mysterious figure replies saying, on Bankai's deathbed, his last wish was to rewrite his wrong. Alpharaima Akuma, Satori Akuma, and D.Va always checked up on you because of Bankai's final wishes. He wanted you to make something of yourself. What we now know from this mysterious person's quote is that Sensei Bankai has done something bad. Anyways, the mysterious figure began to rip something out of his body and blood began to go everywhere, which turned the sky red. Pretty gross. Forged, being a student of Bankai, realized that this was similar to his genjutsu. Then the mysterious figure gives an eye, this eye being the eye of Rengoku. A few months pass after Forged gets the Rengoku eye, and another little detail is that the third Great Shindo War comes up. I'm not really sure if it's that important because, I mean, they just kind of glossed over the thing inside the cinematic, but I guess there's fighting and stuff, and then Forged attacks nothing. And then you just have to fight against it. So I'm guessing that he just attacks the Shindo Alliance or something like that. But yeah, something like that happens, and then Forge has the Rengoku Eye. Here's some screenshots. You guys can pause the screen of what Ro wrote so you can read in more detail, but what I just did was just glossing over the idea. More details. We also know that at some point in time, Ryon Akuma, Forged and Shiver's brother, obtains a Rengoku Eye. This is of course because of the bloodline Ryon Rengoku. Aftermath. Nothing really is much said about what happens after Forged obtains a Rengoku, because up to that point, all we really know of the main story is D.Va attacking the village and Forged obtaining a Rengoku. But the only thing we really know is that Ryan Akuma and Narumaki become rivals, just like Naruto and Sasuke. And Narumaki has a son, or a predecessor, not really confirmed, named Borumaki. Anyways, yeah, that's basically what there is to the entire Shindo Life storyline so far. I'll always make an update video when new information comes out, and I'll make sure you guys know all the secrets. Make sure you guys like and subscribe if you enjoyed this video, and if you think you learned something out of it. I tried to go into more details of everything that happened, but yeah, that's basically it. Anyways, guys, that was the Shindo life story so far, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye!